After a 16-hour ballot marathon that started at Monday 4 a.m. Pacific time, the voices of overseas Filipino voters were counted. At the Los Angeles Philippine Consulate, which has some 35,000 registered voters, 13,489 voters cast their ballots, leading to a 38% turnout, the highest for Los Angeles overseas voting.
Very orderly. We witnessed a very high level of participation from our registered voters here in Los Angeles and our observers.
And it could have been more as voters continued to attempt to drop off completed ballots well beyond the 4 a.m. deadline. Unlike Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.'s apparent landslide victory in the Philippines, Los Angeles saw a neck-and-neck race with Leni Robredo getting 6,174 votes against Marcos's 5,911. The vice presidential race was even closer, with Sara Duterte edging out Kiko Pangilinan 6,018 to 5,919. Poll watchers from both sides knew that Robredo would fare better among U.S.-based voters, who had been staging massive pink rallies.
I'll borrow the words of a friend who's also part of the poll watch team. She said it's a testament of the organizing of the Leni Kiko team in Southern California.
I think it is expected. Yeah, because knowing that, because I belong to the red side. See, and I knew that in Southern California or Northern California, we had the most of the pink side. So, you know, they haven't finished yet, but I think the results will be good, but that won't be enough to take down that margin of, you know, that landslide.
I'm surprised, but not that much. But I'm still hoping that we were able to choose a good leader. And, you know, whatever may happen, we have to move forward.
The top 12 senators included familiar political and showbiz names. Lauren Legarda, Chiz Escudero, Riso Ontiveros, Dick Gordon, Robin Padilla, Mark Villar, Chel Docno, Rafi Tulfo, Mig Zaburi, Gibo Teodoro, and Antonio Trillanes. Consulate officials began transmitting the official results to the embassy in Washington, D.C. shortly after the count.
With the 2022 presidential elections now in the books with a record turnout, the question is, will the 2025 midterm elections also generate as much buzz, involvement, and votes from Filipinos in the U.S.? Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.